Hey guys, welcome to the review of Kingkong Smart 100, which is from Banggood. I think it's a good alternative to the famous, infamous QX95 from Eachine, but it's a pretty good quad and it's quite cheap as well. So I purchased this from Banggood actually, sorry, from a local dealer, but they get their stuff from Banggood about a month ago to be exact. It comes in two flavors, which is one is a bind and fly and one is a kit version. The kit version obviously you have to assemble. I got the bind and fly because I'm too lazy to solder all these small joints, sorry, small wires into the FC. Anyway, this is the bind and fly version. My friend, this is my friend's quad actually. I'm setting it up for him. So it comes like this out of the box. The VTX is on top, the FC and the receiver are inside, hopefully you can see it. This is a Redcon spektrum receiver, that's why it's a diversity receiver. I'm not sure if it's full range, but the range is pretty good, as you'll see later in my FPV video that I'll link to. So it's a diversity receiver. There's also another version, which is a FreeSky, FR Sky version. It comes with a little AC800 receiver, which you can see here. It's very small compared to the Redcon spektrum receiver that it comes with. So this is the Redcon receiver. This is the AC800. Although I swapped it out because I didn't like the range on this little thing. It is little. It's nice. It's small. It's way lighter than the Redcon, but the receiver is horrible because the range is like maybe 100-150 meters. I tried, that's for open area, open space, nothing in between me and the quad. I tried it also in a parking garage. Maybe 6-7 cars away, it kept going to failsafe, so I didn't like this receiver. My friends recommended a spektrum receiver from Redcon. I'm not sure where it's made, probably in China, but it's also available in Banggood, with this receiver. I'll put in links to the description in the description below to the receiver. It's a Spektrum DSM receiver. It's pretty good, so it's like I said, it's diversity. It has two antennas sticking out. The range is really good compared, and the penetration through walls. You know, I fly from here and then outside my house. The range is really good. I lose video most of the time because this is a 25 milliwatt VTX. I lose video way before I have any glitches or failsafe on this receiver. So anyway, onto the quad. Like I said, this is the bind and fly version. It comes with, I think, if I remember correctly, because I bought them a month ago, it comes with 10 pairs of 65mm Kingkong props, which is pretty good. It comes with a 550 milliamp hour battery, 1S LiPo, obviously, with a micro loci. Is that what these connectors are called? I think. Anyway, the VTX is a 16-channel VTX, and it comes with this little chart. Hopefully you can see it on camera. It comes with this little chart. Because the VTX has two LEDs, which I'm going to show you right now, by powering it on. Give me a second. So there you go. You can see the VTX is flashing, right? So it says, sorry, it shows red, white. There's two flashes, red and white. So you just look it up on the chart, red and white, which is 5769. You simply press once on this button. Now it's green, red, which is this next one, next frequency up on the chart, which is 5806. I'm not sure if these are race band channels. I think they are. But anyway, it's a simple button press to move on to the next frequency. And like I said, it only has 16 channels, but you know, I don't use all the 32, so that's fine with me. Anyway, the FC is an Alien Flight F1, which I believe is a NACE 32 brush, but in Betaflight, you choose the Alien F1 target. So it comes stock flash with Clean Flight 1.12, I would like to say. But I did upgrade it really as soon as I got it out of the box. I flashed Betaflight 3.0.1 and stock PIDs it flew well. Although I did see on YouTube or I think Reddit that people with QX95s are using like double the Betaflight PIDs, which is for the pitch and the roll and the D, I simply doubled them and it flies fine for me. The PIDs handle well. in the outdoors with slight wind, and I like it because they're perfect for indoors, which is where I fly this little bugger. I like flying outdoors too, but in outdoors when there's small amount of wind, it still handles fine, and then I don't have to change my PIDs for indoors, which is perfect. So, like I said, it comes with 10 pairs of props, and like, because I'm using the Spektrum version Redcon receiver, if you have a Tranis like I do, I do have an orange Spektrum module, which I bought off Hobby King for about $25, I think. Anyway, which is, if you're gonna get this and you have a Spektrum radio, I would highly suggest having the Redcon receiver, which is really good. You'll see the range later in the FPV video. If you're getting the Free Sky version because you have a Tranis, you will be stuck with this a little AC800 Free Sky protocol receiver, which I suggest change it out immediately to something, you know, something that you would use for Free Sky. Any other receiver, anything but this, because this is plainly crap. So I'll show you the FPV video. You'll see the range. I didn't do anything to the FPV to the video except for editing out some, you know, make it a bit nicer, adding a bit of more music. So the camera is a 600 TVL camera, as it comes, as it says in the manual on the box. You'll see what the camera quality is. And hopefully YouTube doesn't compress the video too much so that it comes out really nice. So anyway, onto the video.